There, right there. It's all good. All right, it's 10:10. Let's get this shit started. Hello, everybody. How are you doing? Welcome to Anime Talks 2. Anime harder. We got some new anime that just aired this past week that didn't air the week before.
There's a lot.
So we're gonna, it's like three. We're gonna hit the ground running with this anime right here called Ajin.
Thanks for that input, Diego.
I found a site that had good subs.
I mean, I'm sure there's good subs now on Kiss Anime, but when it came out, it was poopy.
Yeah, it was. I had to pause. I was like, all right, I gotta interpret this.
See, I'm so smart. I just read it as I knew it was gonna be.
What y'all think of the first episode?
It was predictable.
Predictable.
Yeah, I knew he was a Jin or whatever.
How did you know?
Because it's obvious. Like, the second it started, I was like, he's gotta be one.
I mean, what else is he gonna be?
That's what I'm saying, it was predictable.
Human.
But it's not gonna be interesting if it's a story about a guy who just knows of a Jin.
Maybe he's friends.
He could be a fighter.
Maybe he's friends with a Jin.
Yeah, look,
Juan
got it. See, what are you talking about?
Yeah, they don't have no friends.
It could have been, like, his mom or something.
Like the because in this one Bionicle movie, it started off as about this one dude, but then it turned out that his companion was the chosen one.
Damn, that must have sucked.
Yeah, it did.
So this is this guy, but his friend. That's the one you want to look out for.
Maybe. The side character is the OP one.
Like, why would you want to watch an anime about a guy who's friends with the interesting one?
I mean,
when you could just watch the interesting one.
Different point of view.
Like,
the interesting one's been
like
done over and over again.
Don't care about, and then others you're like, hey, man, it's
kind of OP. That one's pretty tight. What do you guys think about that blonde dude? Do you think he's in a Gen 2 or not?
Man, like if he's not, he's a part of it somehow.
I'm gonna say no.
I'm gonna say he is.
I mean, whenever he did that that jump kick, I thought he took that officer's head off. I was like, oh shit! But then the officer was all like, they're running.
I think he might be part of like some secret society of
Lieutenant
fighters.
Like, They hide the Ajin from society.
The good ones, not the bad ones.
What do y'all think's in his backpack?
Supplies.
Food
for a gun.
The next week to get to the base.
The vaccine.
It's gonna be fucking Matrix where he's gonna be like, all right, you can continue being an Ajin, or I can give you this pill. You can just forget all about it.
Right.
In the anime.
Alright, based on this first episode, what'd y'all give this?
A 2.
A 2?
2.
Out of what?
Fucking 100?
Nah, I feel like I'm really gonna like this one. I'm gonna go with 8 or 9.
Yeah.
I like the whole, I like how they added the whole God's Army thing. Like,
I give
I
it a 7.
A 7.
I'm giving
this probably gonna be 8 or 9 for me. Some people were comparing it to there was, they said that they were getting the Tokyo Ghoul vibe from it.
Mm-hmm. I was gonna say Parasite. Not so much Tokyo Ghoul.
Alright, that was a Jin. Alright, on to this next one right here. Let's call it Active Raid Kido Kyo Shu Shitsu Dai Heka Hake. God damn.
Yeah, that one.
The cop anime.
See if I get it.
Of the future.
Of the future.
What'd y'all think of this second episode?
Let me,
Oh, man. I liked how she just went fucking ape shit on the dude.
Yeah. Like, she was like, I passed all these things, all these tests, all these, you know, simulators, and then goes overpowered.
Like, she hit that wall, she was like, oh, shit, what is all this stuff? Like, you know.
Yeah.
But then she still just went ape shit on the game.
Yep.
You know,
I mean,
it reminded me of like how like some people don't fucking, I guess, check what they install, and so they get a bunch of shit.
Yeah.
Bunch of like extra shit that downloads on there.
Yeah.
I've been on the receiving end of that.
Dumb bitch.
Fuck you.
Okay, I forgot Fredo was here again.
Alright, what's up?
I'm guessing you're not watching this, Fernando?
No, I don't get into the conversation till Dagashi Kashi.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah. What were you saying? What?
I mean, that was pretty cool. Freaking that one guy who's like, but Captain! Like, he wanted to go do that shit. They didn't let him.
That guy looks like a... He seems like a loose pistol, you know what I mean? Like, he always wants to be...
A loose cannon? A loose
pistol!
They both shoot out projectiles.
Yeah, but one's stronger than
the other. I mean...
By a lot. Can we end this one already?
Yeah, alright. That was Active Raid Kido Kiyoshu Tsudai Hake. On to the next one. This is all Moises.
What is
it? On Satsu Kiyoshitsu TV.
I just had something to add from the last one. Hold on, where's my... Okay, yeah, it's just because... Oh no, fuck, I stuck it to us. That's speaking. But pretty much, you get reward money for killing the teacher, and the reward money is 10 billion yen. Yeah, that's a lot of money. It's 10 billion yen, but if you... Like, you can do it in a group, but if you do it in a group, the person that gets the kill is the one that gets the money. Like, they don't divide it, but I mean, I'm sure if that guy wants to be a nice guy, he can be like, here, you help me out, you can get half. But now, they raised it to 30 billion yen, and you can have, like, pretty much there's, like, a max of three people will get 10 billion each. But, I mean, once again, I'm guessing if you have more, then you can just divide it evenly if you want, but... They pretty much raise it to where you can do it in a group of three and you each get 10 billion.
Okay.
Yeah, all right. That's pretty much it.
All right. That was Ansatsu Kiyoshitsu TV second season, brought to you by Kylo Ren.
What the fuck?
My beanie's in my face. All
right. This next one. I don't know Kanata no Four Rhythm. What'd y'all think of this episode right here?
Which one?
Oh, the Flying Circus one.
Yeah, Flying Circus.
Oh, that one?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean,
it was a letdown, plot-wise. Like, I'm not saying the episode was bad. I'm saying what happened in the story let me down. Because I was expecting her to do that kick a second time, or at least get one point.
I mean, she was about to, but then you're like, time. You know?
Yeah.
That's flame.
Did how many points did the first chick get on her before she was able to get 9?
Yeah.
So, what was it this time? Like 4?
9.
There's still 9?
Yeah.
9 and 0.
So she got worse.
She got
score wise.
Because she got new shoes though.
She was never good.
she was getting adjusted to her new shoes.
She got cocky.
She got blank.
Yeah.
I don't think I have any fingers though.
Yeah, not really. I mean,
it wasn't that eventful.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, they got that. I think that guy's gonna join. Like he's
oh, yeah. Now.
But he's in it. They should have. I don't know, man. You know?
Yeah, totally, man.
That chick was being pretty brutal, though. Or she just kept going like, you know, she just get racking up the points.
Man, whenever you know how in like every other anime, whenever the friends enter a tournament and they have to fight each other later on, they agree that they got to go all out.
Yeah,
that was never an agreement at the beginning of this one.
But it's implied. You just
your description is flawed.
It's just what you do.
All right. That was Aono Kanata no 4 rhythm right there. Mm-hmm. Next one. Really good one. Boku Dake ga inai michi.
Ooh. Now this one right here. Man.
What about it?
I don't know, man.
Diego was like, man, this one right here.
What is this one right here?
Go in on it, Diego.
Right off the bat, it caught my attention. It was just like, this episode was just freaking crazy. Just,
it was like, ba-bang.
He started realizing what was going on, and then he was like, whoa, I got to change some stuff up right here.
Started talking.
Go ahead.
I really like the fact that they thought of how, like, they thought of all the stuff that he would have forgot at that age.
Yeah.
Like, oh, hey, yeah. And of course, I love the intro and outro.
Oh, yes.
They make hamburgers weird.
I guess. It's like having a salad and then meat on the side.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like, where's the bread at? You know?
it's mixed in with the hamburger one.
Oh, dude. Nah, but he made a bold move right there. He's all like,
I'm gonna give you the first invitation.
Oh yeah, dude. That shit right there was like
trying to get independence.
He was like, check it out. I want you. I like you and I want you.
Nah.
We can like, do this the easy way, we can do this the hard way.
You're just like, hey, come to my party. You're the first one that I invited.
And then nobody else shows up, just her.
What if he just intentionally uninvites everybody? Yeah, or just doesn't know. I was like, deep. The fucking, his mom caught on to it though.
Yeah.
He's like, you got a girlfriend? He's like, no shit.
You didn't know.
I'm a fucking heartbreaker, mom. Where you been?
Yeah, oh shit, I'll come back to you.
Yeah. Was he laying?
What?
Okay. Was he, when his mom got home, was he just like on the floor?
Yeah, he was just laying there.
Yeah, he like fell asleep on the ground.
Oh.
Faggot.
Fuck.
Watch that melt.
Alright.
Yeah, faggot.
Anything else?
What? I know I said this last episode, but I'm really hoping some plot twist comes up to where he like messes it up this second chance that he gets, and he has to go back again.
That probably happened like on episode 6 or something. Somehow she's gonna die. She's gonna be like, damn it.
I'll be like, fuck.
All right. All the progress. Erased.
Oh.
Right there. All
right. Well, that was Boku Dake ga inai michi. On to the next one.
Are we not saying what we would rate it anymore? Or?
That was the first episode, Josh.
We're gonna wait till the end.
Second. Oh, we you guys. Never mind. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it was a gin.
I get it.
Don't ask dumb questions.
This next one right here is called Bubuki Brunk. This shit, like, got really good for some reason.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got like, better than I thought it was gonna be in the first episode.
Like, that shit was badass.
And it hit you out of nowhere. It was like, you know, check this out.
Oh, here it is.
Robot is OP as fuck.
I found it. Oh, it's broken.
Uh-huh. That shit's cool like though. Like fucking how every part, everyone in the squad controls a part of the Bubuki.
I think that's gonna get too complicated.
Yeah,
it's gonna be OP.
Well, I mean, with that one guy that wants to own the freaking robot.
Yeah, you got the fucking left leg guy saying, "Don't bark orders at me."
But he still did the shit. He still did it.
Are they dead?
It'd be a lot faster if he just controlled the whole robot himself.
Yeah, but that'd be no fun.
Yeah, you wouldn't have the conflict in it, you know?
Yeah, then where would you be?
Yeah, dude.
Plus, what if he's an
overpowered robot?
What if he needs somebody that's uncontrollable to do unpredictable things?
Yeah, I mean, friggin' Diego said something while we were watching it. And like, what if the red haired chick's the sister?
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, nah, dude.
Yeah, no, that shit was.
Yeah, I got debunked in like the next 5 minutes of the episode. Because like, they were like, she still got that 16-year-old body from 24 years ago.
Oh, yeah. And then what did. What do you mean?
No, this one, second episode got really good.
Yep.
And then,
I mean, usually that would be really good in the second episode.
Yeah. That's true. What'd you think of it, Fernando?
Zero out of ten.
Alright, that was Bubuki Baranki. Alright, Fernando, you can talk right now. Because up next is Dagashi Keshi.
That pineapple beer was OP.
That shit, man. When she started acting drunk, I was like, go sit down.
It was like Stewie with apple juice.
Right. Oh, that annoyed me for some reason. I don't know why.
Did it?
Yeah, right. Like,
I don't know. Me, it was just too obvious of a joke.
Yeah. You know.
Yeah.
I thought she was gonna start like trying to kiss him or something though.
Nah, man. I think he would have freaked out and ran out of there.
I mean, that other time that supposedly she liked him, he didn't go anywhere. He got happy.
You're right.
He's a dumb bitch.
Hey.
That was even his first initial thought was, like he's like, we're just kids.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was like, but we're just kids.
And like, whenever she was like, you want to grow up with me? He didn't run either.
Freaking man, that shit. I was like, what you talking about?
He's a guy though. Would you run?
Sure. Yeah.
Nah,
friggin' did they reference another anime in this one? I feel like they did.
Yeah, they probably did. I mean, I just forgot.
With what?
Damn, they did, but I can't think of what it was.
Yeah.
I mean, I know they were talking about the little chip things having anime characters on them.
Nah.
No,
it was something that they did. Fuck. Oh, I can't remember. Well, they referenced it.
Oh, the whistle? The whistle?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. Whatever those people were like, he has a hole in him. He's worthless. Like, oh, my God.
But that story was better than Sushi Police.
That's fucked up.
I gotta agree though.
Friggin' what was that dude's name?
Coconuts?
No, the gum. The gum guy.
Is it these or with an F?
The gum guy.
Yeah. Cause remember there was the younger whistle dude and the older.
You mean the Ramune gum or something like that?
I think that was wrong. No, it wasn't Ramune. It was something else. He's the best. 10 out of 10.
What was it?
Probably some stupid.
Yeah. But right as of this episode, I'm convinced that he's gonna go with Coffee Girl.
Oh yeah, it's definitely gonna be Coffee Girl.
Yeah, man.
Not even.
Man, that candy girl is gonna ditch his ass. Yeah,
man, all she cares about is candy. She's a candy digger.
He's candy.
A candy digger.
He's man candy.
He's not even a man. He's a coconut.
Coconut candy then.
Coconut. Like anything sweet.
So.
That's the soap. He doesn't like.
She ate the candy that he gave her though.
Just because he gives it to her.
Exactly.
They're gonna get together, man.
Anything else?
No. And I just thought it was funny whenever they're playing that game and that girl was like,
diagonal slice.
Yeah. Triple kill. And the other chick, the candy chick was like, master, teach me. That shit right there.
That shit's pretty fun. Anything else? No, that's it. Alright, well, that was the Gashi Keshi. On to this next one that was badass. Dimension W.
Dimension W right there.
This episode was, like, it hasn't stopped being badass ever since it started.
It's still up there.
Yep.
10 out of 10.
Still my favorite from this season.
I want them to make a figure of that. Of what happened to that dude?
What dude?
The one
he got Dimension W.
Yeah. Oh, the rich guy?
Yeah.
Oh, that shit, man. Yeah,
that shit looks bad.
Yeah.
Whenever they, like, split his head in half, that shit was crazy. Like,
I'm guessing that was just, like, a preview of, like, some even more badass scene that's going to happen later on, though. Like, it's going to be, like, 100 people just all fused together.
Jesus.
Fucking sick.
I like the dude's fighting style with the needles.
Yeah.
That guy right there.
Attack on Titan.
I wanted to see the fighting styles of the other guys, the other other anti-coil fighters that he used to be with.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
They look cooler than him.
I mean, I think they might be all dead.
Yeah, they're all gone.
Yeah, because that guy loser was like, I know you're part of that one battalion from back in the days, but they're all gone. So how did you survive? Or something like that. It was crazy.
What do y'all think that that numbers thing is?
I think it's like a kid or something. Like, something big, you know?
Like, you know the new Tesla guys, you know they're hiding something.
Yeah.
And of course, it's the numbers that's gonna show whatever it is that they're hiding.
It's gonna open a gate.
Turns out there's 11 dimensional.
maybe that little thing is like, I guess a key, and like there's like a lock thing at every one of the things in the world system.
Yep. Oh, right. How many of those were there? Like the generator 60. Or power plants?
Like 60-something, I think.
60. Whew. Weren't there only like 9 numbers that were shown?
Yeah, I think so.
60 what divided if... by 9 is 1.
What if there is no W dimension and it's all just some hoax and this is the key to show it?
Oh.
And then all these power plants, it's just like... humans enslaved and being harvested or something. And they just weren't faking this entire time.
There's no way.
Yeah, no way. How would you explain what happened to that one dude?
I have no idea.
Yeah, the doctor.
That doctor's alive somewhere.
He's
keeping up energy somewhere.
He's the force now.
Gee,
what if he just like uploaded himself to fucking just like some database?
That'd be crazy.
I mean, he did have a ton of wires, and he was some awesome inventor that discovered how to abuse the fourth dimension.
That's true.
Pretty much.
Anything else? No, that's it.
All right. I like the intros and outros. I like how he dances.
Yeah, a little dance scene to one of the guys that gets me every time. Like,
watch, that's gonna get popular at cons. Watch.
I forget about it until I see it, and I'm like, oh yeah. Too funny.
All right.
I'm gonna see like 20 people do it in a row, and I'm gonna go slap each and every one of them. Like, no, you're gonna ruin this.
You're gonna slap shit.
Like, don't ruin this for us.
I'll give you the five imaginary dollars I'm gonna get from Moises.
Alright then.
You didn't get shit for me. I forgot what you even
said. Yeah, me too.
Alright, that was Dimension W.
On to the next one. What the fuck?
What?
I'm trying to think of what we bet on.
Oh, we could just look at it, lady.
Alright. This next one is called Divine Gate.
No one to know. Divine Gate.
And to be quiet again.
Yeah, Fernando, shut up.
I'll fuck you up.
Oh.
You can't say anything about this anime.
Me, 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 me.
So right. There are gods.
Yeah, dude.
That was amazing.
And it was Loki, right? That was the god?
Yeah.
We're talking about Divine Gate.
And he was all like, a king needs a god.
Yeah.
You know, so I wonder what he does.
He fucking sends robots.
That doesn't seem like a godly thing to do.
It's pretty godly. Can you send robots? That's what I thought.
Oh, man. Did y'all see the weapons? Was it in the outro or the intro? But they were showing all like a bunch of different weapons that there were going to be. They looked fucking cool.
I think it was the intro.
Intro?
It was in the intro.
Those looked cool. I liked those. I'm going to be looking forward to those.
I like Natsu's power. I mean, what's his name?
I was going to say that. Like, he has a little fist thing and then like come on his hand.
That actually reminded me of the Genos. What is his name?
Genos.
One Punch Man?
Genos.
Yeah.
One Punch! Yeah. And then freaking, whenever he did the slash thing to put out the fire, I thought it didn't do anything.
Yeah, like, for a little while. Really, he failed? So yeah.
He's still a noob to the ways of the whatever this is.
Yeah, but then it started with him.
That shit was funny.
I want to see.
I was like,
I want to see what Blondie does and what Purple Power Chick does.
Purple Power Chick.
I mean, I'm sure you're going to see their weapons in the intro if you went back and looked at it.
Nah, but yeah. I want to know what their shit is.
Like their power, like what they, man, their element, whatever.
Yellow is going to be electricity.
It's going to be light.
It just, what? It's
light, kind of, no. Light and dark.
Light would be white.
Yeah.
Light it can be yellow.
It could also be blue.
Yeah. Yeah. But it's not. Alright, that was Divine Gate. On to this next one.
Y'all bet on managers, Mozo.
Yeah, on the managers.
That's right. The new manager.
Oh, yeah, they're going to be OP.
This next one, Moises and Josh, take it away, because it's Durarara X2K.
Man, Moises. Finally, the head is out of Isaiah's possession. Like, I'm sure he set that up, but...
And it's out on the street.
Yeah, but finally, it's out there. People know about it. Everyone's going after it. It's happening.
It's not happening, you're crazy.
It's happening.
You're crazy.
It's gonna happen.
What's gonna happen?
Everything. Because
everything at once.
In the first season, Izo was talking about how he needs a war for this head to like activate or come alive, and so he's trying, this whole time he's been trying to create some huge war between all the factions. It's gonna happen.
How many factions are there?
There's the Sword, Dollars, well, I guess now there's two factions.
Are you talking about the Psycho people?
Yeah, and well, there's actually multiple different Psycho peoples, because you know how there's two different... Yeah.
I went to try to fight Henri, and I was like, oh.
And then you got the blue squares inside of the Dollars, so you got the two factions in the Dollars, then you got the yellow scarves making a comeback.
Does Kadota's count as its own squad?
Kadota.
Because they have that selfie thing now.
Yeah, right. And now they have the guild, and then all the adult, you know, gangs that there are too. Like, you know how they're talking about the feud between the two families?
Yeah. All I know is you don't go grading around with the dollars. That's a fact.
Yep.
I don't know if I had anything else. Let me check my notes.
I didn't like the songs. The intros and outro.
Hey, fuck you, buddy.
I loved the first season ones.
Yeah. I like the animation and the, like,
oh yeah, the animation's cool.
Like that, but yeah, I don't got anything else other than he has a big ass machete.
I don't think it's just his knife is up close. It's like the perspective drawing. Oh my god.
You're crazy.
Can't wait to see Simon with grenades and guns though. That'll be fun.
He doesn't even need those.
Yeah, like, was he just as strong as Shizuo, or was he stronger?
I don't think he's stronger. He caught that.
Whatever, yeah, he caught that punch.
Vending machine or whatever. Yeah, but he got beat up though. It shows him in that other scene. He got beat up by Shizuo.
Oh shit! Right, he had the bandages and everything. Yeah. Like, right. Yeah,
he's not strong.
Yeah.
Dude, he's close, I guess.
He's almost there.
He's probably the closest one.
Yeah. Yep. Maybe. Well, unless one of the other Russian guys, like the one with all the bandages, or that one chick.
He got his ass whooped.
The one chick that's like following Shizuo right now, though, the Russian chick who's like the thinker, knows everything. I feel like she could like outsmart him, maybe. Because if Izai can outsmart him, then.
Dude, what? No, not even. She could outsmart him.
Yeah, she could.
No.
Oh my god. Izai has made Shizuo get hit by a truck twice.
Yeah, but
this chick can pull some shit out of her sleeves.
No, because that, Shizuo's smart. He started kicking that car down the street so he didn't get shot.
True.
He's not stupid. I mean, it's not like...
I'm not saying he's stupid. I'm just saying she's smart as shit. Like,
but I mean,
she's
he
always
kids though, so he doesn't really, yeah. He doesn't need to be that smart, because yeah. He's pretty much invincible. Like, he got shot, remember?
And Hulk's pretty much invincible, but he was still shot up in space for the whole Civil War thing.
But is he dead?
No, but there's ways. Exactly. There's ways.
And when he comes back, he's gonna fuck shit up. This isn't Hulk Tucker, right? I can bring it in Marvel.
Alright.
That's all I got for this.
All right. That's all I got too.
That was Durarara X2 Ketsu. This next one was pretty good too. It's called Gate Jietai Konochi Nite Kaku Takugari Second Season.
Oh, you won.
That was pretty, it was good. I liked it. Fucking Itami fucked that prince up. Not by himself, not himself, but he ordered that chick to do it.
He got that little girl. Yeah, he got the little girl to do it for him.
She fucked him up, though.
She fucked everybody up. It was just her by herself. She killed, like, fucking 15 guys and then beat the shit out of that dude. I was like, yeah, damn.
Yeah, she's pretty OP.
Yeah. All we had to say is that they made the earthquake look a lot worse in the first episode than when it actually hit. I was like, what the fuck? It was just, like, a little, like, slight, like the fucking in the first episode, like the whole ground was like tearing apart, and then the next episode is like little shakes. And I'm like, what the fuck? This is stupid as hell.
Yeah,
it's fucking dumb. And then I'm also thinking that maybe that sex slave bunny is actually kind of important now. She's not just a first scene from the first ep. She's gonna she's probably gonna have something important.
She's in the opening, so she's got something to do with it. You know.
I mean, she's probably just going to keep getting fucked all the time.
Probably. I mean, she's probably going to want to try and do something, but she's going to end up getting fucked over and over and over.
She's going to have to sacrifice her body to, like, a bunch of people. She's probably going to fuck everybody to death or something. That's about all I can think of.
She is a bunny.
Yeah, so she's going to hop from one to the other. And just as it goes. Yeah, see, we're on the same page. We got it.
Freaking, they need to give Rory, Tuca, and Magic Chick aren't getting, like, screen time at all.
Because they're going to, I don't know. They'll be OP later on.
What are they doing? No.
They're fucking saving lives, bro. Bro.
What do you think, what do you think they're going to do with that one girl whose family got killed?
The blonde one?
No, the one that they say.
The... Oh.
The human.
Fucking, they're going to tell her and she's going to shoot herself in the face. Or just stay there and live amongst the animals. I don't know.
She becomes Snow White.
I wouldn't go back. I fucking... If they told me off my family was there, I'd be like, fuck it, I'm staying here.
Can I join the army?
I don't know about the army.
Alright.
I don't know if I can be that badass. That fucking little girl took out everybody. That place is trying, and they're like, whoa. Who's gonna go sleep?
You think it was kind of douchey? You think it was kind of douchey of them to destroy that Senate place?
No. It was never about the Senate. It's about sending a message.
Oh my god. Okay. Alright. You got anything else?
Nah, I'm guessing I got something like
that. Alright. That was Gate. Gia Taikanochi. Nite Kaku Tata Kari
Kairi. Just fucking say Gate.
Gate. Second season. Fucking shit. I'm trying to make this as authentic as possible.
Fuck
up.
Alright, this next one. Haito Gensu no Grimgar, a.k.a. Alright,
this one right here.
They finally got their first kill.
Yeah.
All I gotta say about that kill is goblins are tough as shit.
Yeah.
But they're the fucking weakest, so this is just gonna get crazier from here.
He took like 15 steps to the chest.
He went to the neck and he was still fucking fighting. Yeah.
And he got hit
with
magic and
great sword to the head.
Damn, he survived that too.
Yeah.
Damn.
Hello, Goblin was like, nah, man, I'm gonna fuck you guys up.
You know, they're not fucking, they're not ready. They're like, the healer guy, he hit the goblin with his staff. Like, healers are supposed to be, you know, in the back, behind everyone, healing people. They're not supposed to be bashing goblin heads.
Well, does he have, like an indirect, like from afar? Like, casting healing thing?
Oh, yeah, he's like, he's all magic and stuff. Like,
he has to be, like, directly in front of you. Maybe he hasn't mastered, like airy, like, fucking distance magic.
Yeah. Isn't he a war cleric?
I think he said he was, like, a priest.
Yeah, a priest.
A war priest?
Right, yeah.
And then the other chick is the, like, all the attack magic stuff. The one with the hat and everything.
Because in Fire Emblem, they got this class where, like, they heal, but they also, like, fuck shit up with their strength.
You crazy.
He's a priest, and priests are always just healers. He's not supposed to be. The melee people need to get their shit together.
Yeah, pretty much.
They seem to be stronger.
The Dark Knight guy, he finally got a little summoning demon thing, so.
Yeah,
he didn't get it yet, did he?
Yeah, he did, because he survived that greatsword hit, and then he was like, no, you stole my kid. And then
he said he had to get a couple more things before he could do it.
No, because he got it from the goblin, I think.
Yeah, he was like, I need to get my first vine or something like that, like my first.
And then he was sitting there on the bridge, and he told everyone what it did, and they were like, I don't see how that's useful at all, but they were still happy anyways.
Yeah.
I'm just happy there's summoning in this too. Like this is gonna be a great anime. Whew.
Yeah, I like how they show how tough it is whenever you're starting in some like game, you know. It's freaking crazy.
I kind of want to know how the you remember that other group, like they like how these are the newbie of the newbie people that came out.
Yeah.
And how the other group, like, I want to see how far along they are.
I mean, I'm pretty sure they're up there. Cause,
like, are they already, like, killing tens of the next tier of monsters and shit?
Yeah.
What's probably the king?
Because right. I do remember them saying that, like, they were already in a guild or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I remember them.
They're all in guilds, though.
Yeah. They're each in their own little individual guild. That's how they got trained.
Yeah.
They had to spend the little 10 days of training.
Yeah, no, you're right, you're right.
Freaking... Oh, that one song in the middle took up like...
Yeah, like...
A lot.
When I saw that song come up, I was like, is that it?
I was expecting, like, credits and...
Right.
Yeah. I'm getting the feeling.
Yeah.
That red hair likes priest dude. or the girl.
Yeah, because she was sitting there just staring at him, but I was expecting her... I had it set in my mind. If she smiles, she likes them as a couple, but if she doesn't smile, she likes the priest dude. Like, that was in my head. And then she did a little smile thing, so I'm assuming... Yeah. She's just okay with them being an item.
Yeah. I like how like that guy was like, "Oh, we're men. We gotta go and do this," you know. He's like, "I mean, you gotta catch up with the program, man."
I'm gonna like that kid, dude.
That guy is funny. And he gets his ass kicked. Get out of here.
I want the thief dude to end up with the magic girl.
Which dude?
Thief.
The thief.
Oh, end up with who?
The magic girl.
But priest is already hitting her up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He's gonna end up with big boy. And then red hair with red hair. Is it gonna happen?
Shit, what is the red haired girl? Oh wait, she's a hunter, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, they'd be okay, I guess.
Yeah.
Red hair and red hair. They're both outgoing.
I thought they were all splitting up at first. I thought they were all pissing each other. I was like, what the fuck?
I'll just take these and go my separate way. Go join a good guild.
Take group. My copper. Those guys over there.
Right. How much copper did they each get from
like
that?
Five.
Oh, that was like, yeah, it was like five or eight.
They sold that one fang and they got like a silver for it.
Yeah, and
yeah, but then they had to split it equally.
How much is the silver?
I don't know.
It's probably 100.
I don't know what the fuck they were doing in the store. How many of them? Like, they just have five copper coins each.
Yeah.
There's six of them.
Yeah.
Like, what were they out shopping for?
I'm just gonna assume. All right, I'm just gonna say it's 48 copper pieces. Again. I'm just gonna assume they got. Let me see.
Cause fuck yeah, that one dude bought got that meat. He was eating that meat, and then the girls went shopping.
They got 9 pieces of meat, or copper.
The girls went shopping. They got some clothes.
Yeah, like how much can you get with 9 copper?
I don't think they got 9 copper. I think they got like 20 each.
They said
it
was single digits. It was
I'm pretty sure it was single digits.
It was either 6 or 8, I think. Goodness, if it was 8, I'm just gonna. Then they got 48 for that one silver piece.
I thought that silver piece was worth 30.
No.
Whenever the thief kid, he was walking around the store and he saw those they looked like homeless.
If it was 30, then they each got 5 pieces.
Yeah. 30 for the silver. And they spent
about 20 each then.
From the tooth thing.
Motherfucker, you stupid.
Because the fucking merchant was all like, oh, is that a dark wolf tooth? You can get 1 silver for that. Or something like that.
Like, oh my god, are you for real?
Yeah.
It's like, it's just a tooth.
I mean, I could just give you my tooth.
But like, he was looking at those homeless adventure types, but they looked more suited up than anyone in his party.
Yeah.
So like, I'm assuming there's going to be a point to where they finish all the quests in this city, and it's going to be like some hard journey to go to the next city, and like, the reason these guys are homeless is because they're just fucking noobs, and they can't get to the next, you know, tier.
If they couldn't get to that tier, why don't they just stay in the tier they're in and they could be doing it?
They looked suited up, like they had, nice metal plate armor and...
They're probably just trash.
Maybe it's just copper.
It wasn't copper.
I would say it was at least iron.
That was Haito Genso no Grimgar. On to the next one, which is Haruchika.
Oh, there's one right here.
I'll be right back.
This one, I like this episode a lot. Cause
I did too. They got me.
They got you.
Yeah, I did. They got you. Whenever they were like, we're gonna solve it together, I was like, they solved it. And then they start pinning. I was like, man, that's stupid. But then like the message came out, and I was like, oh, damn, that's nice right there. That right there. Ooh, yeah. It's pretty nice.
Does it?
Yeah, man.
I thought it was uninteresting, to be honest.
I like it. The only thing I have in my notes is pretty stupid. I don't know how to explain it, but I like when they do, when they were in her room eating the little cake or whatever and coffee, and she was like, he wants to drink coffee for 5 hours just to finish a book or whatever. And she's like, you have 5 minutes. And she looks at it, we have 5 minutes. I like when the other character heard it, but the other character still tells him anyway.
Yeah.
I like when that happens.
Friggin',
we have 5 minutes.
I think. Like the first 6 episodes are gonna be like them getting the squad together.
Oh yeah, they're gonna need how many students did they need just to get to that one stage like, that they get to?
I think they needed like 20.
Yeah. 30, yeah. They're gonna need a.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're gonna need a good amount of people in there.
Good. They're gonna have a bigger problem to solve.
Yeah. Forget the Rubik's Cube. We gotta fix this car.
How do we make people?
He has a cloning device over there.
Is there anything else?
Not really.
Nah. All right.
That was Haruchika, Harutatu, Chika, Waseishun, Subu. On to the next one, which is first episode of this series. Konosubarashi Sekai ni Shuku Fuku wo.
I was laughing through a lot of this.
Yeah, deep.
Like, it was a lot sillier than I thought when it first started.
Yeah.
That was going to be like all girly because of the 3 girls in the cover.
Man. This shit. I fucking love it. Whenever he was in the guild and he was signing up and he was about to get his stats read to him, he was like, all right, this is the part where I get the awesome stats and the whole guild freaks out. And he was average across the board. And then the fucking goddess. Oh my god. That was perfect.
She gets all the good shit.
Yeah.
Her intelligence is rich. She's the part of this
book. Everyone just goes crazy.
They're supposed to be doing like quests and shit. They ended up building shit.
I was sitting there like, what the fuck?
What the fuck are they doing?
And then he finally had like fucking. He finally hit him and I was like, okay, Jesus Christ.
Moises, that scene where they drink the milk, that reminded me of that scene in Durarara whenever they drink the milk.
You're talking about Kono?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you going to talk?
I don't know what y'all said already.
Just say whatever.
Whenever that dude was like, I choose you, I was like, damn. Whenever she said, you can take anything, I was like, he's going to take her.
Yeah.
Take her for sure.
Like, I knew it was going to happen, but it was still funny the way she was reacting anyways.
Yeah, but what made me laugh is that on the way up, he kept doing that evil laugh.
He was just laughing the whole time.
You're fucked now.
And then that second goddess comes in, it doesn't explain shit. She's just like, okay, they're in a bloop. She's like, wait.
She's like, there's gotta be a rule against this. She's like, no, you're going with her.
She said that shit. She's like, no, that's my life.
Watch. In the next episodes, he's gonna get like this rare ass weapon, and he's gonna become OP because of his luck.
Nah, I feel like she's gonna get through.
She got magic. She said she was gonna be like a.
She already got skills.
Whoa. Yeah. But she has low intelligence, and intelligence is for mages.
She said she was gonna be like some priest shit.
Yeah, some arc mage or something.
Arc priest.
Yeah.
Well, that's stupid.
Yeah, I think he's gonna be melee.
He's a merchant.
The main character, because whenever he was first entering this world, he thought he was like, he's definitely gonna be mage, because he told himself if there's magic in the world that he's
gonna do. She said it. They were like,
I'm talking about the chick. I'm talking about the dude.
Oh.
The chick said it. I'm just saying,
why are there gonna be two mages in the same party?
They're not. He's gonna be a merchant.
No, he's not a merchant. No,
he wants to be a magician guy. He told himself that he was gonna be a magician.
But then he said. I want to be. Whenever they were telling him this stuff, he said, "Let me. I want to be like an adventurer." But they're like, "Don't do that. You can be a merchant."
Yeah.
Well, no, they suggested he be a merchant.
Yeah. He said no.
He wanted to be an adventurer. Yeah.
He was like, "Sign me up as an adventurer." After they told him he wanted to that he would be a good merchant, he was like, "No."
Yeah, but I don't think they did that though. I think they said you can change it later.
Yeah, he said if he wanted to, he could change if he wanted later. So they signed him up as an adventurer. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I assume they signed him up as an adventure, and they told him he could always back out if it gets too hard.
That's the impression I got.
Yeah.
Well,
all right.
There's gonna be two more people joining the crew, so.
Yeah. Oh yeah, fucking warrior and magician.
Ooh. Yeah. It's gonna be like Asuna and Kirito.
Damn, there's gonna be a lot of mages in this party.
What are you talking about, Josh?
Because the main guy wants to be a mage, he's going to be an archmage, and there's going to be another, isn't there?
Yeah, and there's a chick with a hat. I'm guessing she's a mage.
She's going to be the mage, and then fucking Aqua's going to be the priest. And then...
He's going to be melee, probably.
He's going to be like Becca. He's going to be a bard.
What?
He's going to be a bard.
What's
bard? The healer?
Nah.
No, the buffer.
The dude?
He's going to be the buffer.
The dude?
Because right here in this goddamn... thing, the picture.
Thing.
He's got like a little sword in his waist and like a sack.
That doesn't make him a bard.
Yeah, but that sword might be OPAF. Like what's it called? Like Bell. Whenever he got that one skill out of nowhere, he turned badass.
We'll see.
All right, I'm assuming it.
What about Denny?
Oh. Are you gonna go right now?
That's like how we always called her useless, and then that one dude was like a, what do you call it? Like how he worshipped a god under her.
Oh yeah.
he still pitied her and was like gave her some money.
Yeah.
I think
that's pretty funny.
I think the early parts of this anime is gonna be like how in One Punch Man he was like solving all his problems, but everyone was calling him like a fake and a phony, and no one knew he was really doing good work. I feel like that's what the early part of this anime is gonna be like for the main character. Like, he's going to be cool, but the whole guild's going to think he's just some, like, noob.
Like, they're probably going to think the chick's doing all the work.
Yeah. And they're just going to be like, man, that poor girl being stuck in a fucking party with that guy.
I actually have two more things. Whenever the lady bought the meat and she, like, threw it over her back and it landed on the little baby's face.
Oh, yeah.
And then I was also going to ask... If you couldn't take the chick, what would you ask for or take with you?
Fucking.
Did they mention some of the other skills. Abilities that there were?
No.
And then unless you read the papers.
Damn. Because, I mean, if summoning's there, then that's my go-to, usually.
I'm talking about an idol.
Oh, just an idol?
Wait, but you said power, too. You can ask for something.
I mean, what, were you expecting me, like, are you asking me what item I would bring if I had to bring an item?
I was just asking what she asked.
Mm.
So you said somebody?
Yeah.
I don't even know who I was.
Excalibur from Fate.
Excalibur from Soul Eater? Oh my god, Fernando. how do you stand him?
No.
Oh.
His... What did the dude get annoyed at? I forgot.
The sneezes, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
What the fuck?
He kept saying how, like, I guess how gross it was or something. Yeah, I think those sneezes.
I can't see shit. But no, I think I'd take exceptional swordsmanship with me.
Like your ability is just exceptional swordsmanship?
Just put my sword stat to max, please.
Yeah. So, alright.
What about you?
Yeah, what would you do, Moises?
It's obvious.
Fists.
Pretty much. The super strength. Or like some OP gloves. Like just punch the shit out of stuff.
That was Konosubarashi Sekai ni Shukufuku wo. On to the next one, which is Kokaku no Pandora.
I don't know how I'm feeling about this one.
Why?
Like
is it getting too edgy for you?
Like, I didn't like that chick's gonna have to do that
exactly
every single time. I thought it was just a one-time thing.
Exactly. Other than that, shit went down in this episode at least. Like, it got better now. It went crazy.
All I have to say is, I knew that third arm was a dick.
What?
The second I saw it. The guy that came out of the little capsule, he had like three little things like that. I was like, that's a dick. And then she was like, can you shut it down or something? So what's her name doesn't get crushed. And then he was like, if you show me your pants, she's like, okay. And she was like, it just like floats up and it's like going up. And I was like, yeah, I knew it was a dick.
Oh my god.
It was fucking stupid.
How'd y'all feel about that? What do we call it? That tentacle scene where she got fixed.
Yeah, that too. I was like,
oh yeah.
That wasn't necessary.
Yeah, that's pretty much the thing that I saw. I was like, all right.
I laughed a bit whenever it was like the giant eye thing, and they were like, oh, it's calmed down, and then it just shot a giant ass laser. Yeah. I liked that.
Freaking.
So that sacrifice, though.
Yeah. She sacrificed herself.
What are you talking about?
What?
It was a sacrifice.
Yeah, fucking weight. I like how they made fun of her for the weight limit. And then she just straight up sacrificed herself. Like, she's how alive. Bad? How bad did they have to fucking feel?
Nah. She's alive, son.
She's a robot.
I'd believe
it. It's pretty stupid because, I mean, they blew the roof off. So, I mean, if the water gets up high enough, she could just swim to the top.
Yeah, that's true.
That's true.
And also, like, is anybody going to agree with me?
I nodded my head.
That's pretty much all I thought. I was like, she can just went to the top. I was like, what the fuck?
Freaking conceited ass doctor.
The doctor?
Not that. Scientist, whatever the fuck she is. Oh, man. Alright, anything else?
Nah, all I had on my notes was the dick thing.
Right. Oh, I don't know why, but I had a problem with them showing the sinking thing in the intro.
What?
Who watches intros? Know.
For real.
I don't know.
Shut down.
But one watches intros, you're not alone.
Never miss an intro.
If it's good, I'll not miss it.
Yeah. To the next one.
Do a little head nod.
All right, that was Kokaku no Pandora. This next one is probably gonna be really good.
Really good.
Luck and Logic.
I like Luck and Logic.
Oh, I don't want to talk about that.
I think it's gonna be pretty average.
It looks like it has some sort of potential.
I really like the gun girl, and I liked how that fortune telling guy turned out to be fucking nothing.
Oh my god, yeah, dude, he's like,
Like, we're sitting here thinking he's, like, in some, you know, VIP, super class, high up there ranking. Nah.
He just hasn't found a coven to.
Oh, that show's funny.
Man.
But, dude, his logic hours compared to that one captain chick.
She thought, she was all like, I got this guy beat.
That actually reminds me whenever people like compare their anime lists.
Oh, yeah.
Her hours are a smaller version of his hours.
Inside jokes, crazy today.
I think I'm gonna like this a lot because I like, I guess when like stuff combines, and like they're going to this badass shit. You know what I'm saying?
Wait, what do you mean? What do you mean combined? Like,
because like you know they fucking combine.
Oh, just the goddess and whoever. Yeah. Oh.
I'm really into all that, and then I'm also into armor.
I mean, I think. Up to start, it's pretty okay, but like Josh said, I feel like it's gonna be an average anime.
Yeah, it's gonna be. Did
armor change?
Huh? No. Or
it didn't.
I think he got a cape, but that's it.
Yeah.
Okay, because I felt like whenever he did the second transformation ever to go, what did he do?
He went to care of the little kid.
The sand.
Yeah, whenever he did that, I felt like it looked different. I was like, did he do that? From whatever he was doing, the little simulation thing.
He grew a cape.
Yeah.
But I didn't go back and check, so I was just like, ah, I'll see if they can film it for me.
That's it. Friggin' blonde chick's dumb as fuck.
Oh my god.
She's like, bloop. And she's like, that didn't count.
Blondie incorrect.
It's pretty, I think. Like it's pretty cool how they can like change their weapons and stuff, you know.
Like the gun girl. Yeah. She went from like sniper to assault rifle.
Yeah, and then freaking sword. The sword chick went from great sword to like dual blades.
Yeah.
Did Vita have anything to like actually attack with?
Shield.
Or was it just a shield.
Shield.
Nah, yeah, he just has the shield, but it can like I think it can turn into like a saw like thing, I guess.
Maybe. I think he hits him with the counter.
Didn't he? Yeah, he reflected it, didn't he?
Yeah. Oh yeah. You're right. Because he like took in the power and then he
yeah.
Some kind of reflection.
So he's like Dan Straight from Fairy Tail.
Yeah.
Dan Straight.
All right. Anything else?
Nah.
All right. That was luck and logic. This next one, I started watching. Mahou Shoujo Nate Mouli Desukara. It's funny. Super funny.
Oh, the magic girl?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She
put it right. Whenever that dude was all like, you must have been so loved.
She was like, it's okay. Like, you have me now. She's like,
yeah. Like she just interrupted him and everything.
Yeah, it was like so quick.
No thought.
It's instant.
I like how
you can go.
I like how she's quickly picking up all the things she could do with the water, though. She quickly thought to drown him. She quickly thought to try and heal the wound with the water.
She's
a natural.
I mean, yeah. That's why she got chosen.
From the trash bags.
Well, I was gonna ask what that dude's name was. The Digimon that had, like, he looks just like a fucking Digimon.
I forgot his name. I forgot his name.
Fuck. Well, he knows what I'm talking about, so.
Yeah. He also looks like a Yu-Gi-Oh card.
I don't know anything about Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yeah.
Alright. I'm sure he does.
Anything else?
Nah, that's pretty
much it. Mahou Shoujo Nate Mouli Desukara. On to this next one.
Wait, which, what? Are you and Josh watching it now?
Yeah.
So what would you guys rate it then?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, oh, yeah.
Nine. 9 out of 10.
7 or 8.
Alright, that was Mahou Shoujo non-technology discard. On to this next one, where Josh insists is ecchi.
It's... No, I'm not saying it's ecchi, I'm saying it's got a lot of fan service.
I think it's ecchi. I still like it, though.
It's not. It's OP.
It's ecchi.
It's ecchi on... It's ecchi on the one website. I don't know if we're allowed to say websites.
I said it already. I think you said it.
I mean, as long as you don't give the whole URL.
.com?
I mean, what else do you... But, yeah.
What do y'all think of this episode?
All I have in my notes is the puppy.
I don't like the headphone girl's ability.
You know?
It's a two-part?
I thought it was going to look a lot cooler, you know, not be as annoying.
Yeah. She has to say the whole rhyme every single time. And blah, 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 blah.
It's got to rhyme every single time.
Yeah, they all do. Yeah.
Yeah, they all have a rhyme to say.
Oh, except.
Yeah, but except the chick just does it once and she has for the
eater
powers.
Girl. Except for the eater girl.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but they all just say it once, and they have the power. She has to say it every single time.
Oh, yeah, they only have to do it once.
No, if she, like, messed it up, she'd have to do it. She'd have to touch herself all over again.
Yeah.
Well, when she actually does it, she doesn't have to keep saying the rhyme. Unlike this.
She only had to do it over and over because that one, because that other dude was fucking her up.
Yeah, and then, she has, like, it's a two-parter, so she has to say two different rhymes to activate both powers.
Yeah, like, she stabs him, and then she eats him, or whatever.
I don't know. I bet it was annoying.
Yeah, I was expecting something a lot cooler.
That's why she has headphones on, so she has to hear herself.
I don't know, I mean...
like, the way they introduced her, I thought she was going to be, like, an OP one that they were. It was going to be hard to convince her to get into the team.
If you think about it, she's both the fucking the damage and the seal.
And I am assuming that the longer the chant, the more greater the power. How it usually, so you know, the two parter chant, then it's probably stronger than most chants.
I still thought she was maybe more OP.
Yeah.
I like how the dude was like so excited about his summoning powers.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I like how they presented the dog.
Yeah. It looks like a badass little demon dog, and then.
And then the fire disappears, and it's just the puppy.
Yeah, it's just a little tiny little thing, little cub.
Right now, this is number one on new and hot.
Yeah.
On Kiss Anime.
Yep.
It is.
It is.
Dimension W. I thought it was cooler.
I feel like it's only like that because of the fan service. Because the second hottest one is straight up edgy.
What's the second hottest one?
Cupid's. Yeah.
What the fuck?
It's on episode 7, right?
Like, the only reason this one is as popular as it is because it's fans.
I thought it was pretty good, even without, like, the edginess.
I hope there's less of it later on.
No, dude, there's going to be more and more and more forever.
I mean, up to now, it looks like that's going to be the only dude in the team.
Nah. So
I just want to see something, you know, better.
Alright.
I want to see him actually get cool with the summonings, though.
That's not going to happen.
That's going to happen. Why?
Let's just stay silly.
Yeah.
What?
Maybe. Yeah.
I'm wanting to see the puppy fuck shit up.
He'll probably evolve.
Alright. Y'all got anything else?
Nah.
Alright, that was Musaigen no Phantom World. What would you rate it for Nando since you started watching?
10.
Right.
10.
On to the next one, which might be my favorite anime of the season. Nijiiro Days.
Boys, actually, I had something to mention to you directly. because of this episode. The kiss steal.
Oh.
The kiss steal.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That one's not as bad, though, because she doesn't like anybody else. Like, if she likes some dude and then that dude came in and kissed her for no reason, I would have been upset, but I didn't really care for this one.
Pretty good. It's good. I think she likes that girl.
Yeah. She was a lesbian, then I'd be upset, but it's not that she likes her, she's just one of those people that nobody talked to, and then when you finally somebody finally talks to you, then you just open up to them pretty much.
That's true. And then fucking
She's fucking hilarious though. Like anytime the dude just glances at her, she's just like, "What?"
Spit on that motherfucker face. just spit on him. I was like, "God damn."
And then whenever that redhead dude went to go ask the brown-haired dude, friggin', when do you know to kiss someone? And he's all like, when I want to. And then, what if they don't want you to, or something like that? And then he's all like, I'll tie him up. this is probably gonna be my favorite anime, too, because this rip is fun, you know.
Yeah, it's really good. I like it.
Yeah. I wish it was longer, but that was all right. Y'all got anything else? All right, that was Nijiiro dates. On to this next one, which got better as well. Norn and no net.
No, I still don't like it.
Yeah, I still don't like it.
I like this episode better because
I liked it better, but I still don't like it.
The second episode is always better.
I don't know how I feel about this one right here. It's something.
Who do y'all think is the inside guy?
I don't know. I mean,
the peach tree. That,
what the fuck?
I think it's the plant guy.
Nah.
The one that's all like kissy kissy to her.
Yeah.
This was retarded when he was like, we should bathe together and sleep together and together and together. Like,
what if it's the girl?
Who wants that ass?
Oh, yeah, and she, like, doesn't know she is or something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm. That could also be a possibility.
She hit him with the counter, though.
Yeah, that shit was crazy. It was just like... I don't know. I mean, so far, I like it, but it's not. You know, it hasn't caught my attention that much.
It's a good buffer anime for when you're waiting for other anime.
Yeah.
It's gonna get better.
Hopefully.
I promise you that. It's gonna get better. That's all I'm saying right now. You're gonna be like, oh my god.
Yeah, that peach tree's gonna, it's gonna grow.
It's dead. That's just dead.
That little peach seed that you saved, it's gonna grow.
Alright, so that's
how better it's gonna get.
That was Norn 9, Norn and no net. This next one, which is fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
Ojisan, yeah. Too much.
That should make me laugh. How she sees him in the rain and she's like,
"Oh yeah."
Yeah. She was like, "I gotta get this guy's attention."
Funny. And then the whole time he's just like, "Oh, was she a klutz or something?" Yeah, she had a.
She did see.
Yeah.
It shows funny.
Whenever he was talking on the phone with that one dude.
Oh yeah.
This kind of very subtle fan service, like I don't even count it as fan service, because that's that stuff that's realistic. Like that stuff people would actually do.
Yeah. that right there. I couldn't stop cracking up whenever she started like, oh.
Turn the stereo down on that one.
Yeah. Oh, that right there. That made me laugh.
All right. Or anything else?
Are we gonna wait for Moise to get back?
Not fuck that. That was Uji-san to Marshmallow. The next one is 2 minutes long, basically. It's called Ooyasan wa Shishunki.
Dude, the intro's like half the episode.
Yeah,
dude.
Yeah.
I like how the credits are at the bottom, though.
Yeah.
Episode. Yeah. Like, I wish that was with every anime.
Dude, 2 minutes? Like, the whole episode was just 2 minutes and something seconds.
Yeah. But it's pretty funny. It's, you know,
I laughed a bit whenever the that second girl, she like interrupted the indirect kiss thing.
Yeah.
He was like, oh, indirect kiss.
Oh, that shit right there.
It's like commercials between animes.
Yeah, that's what it feels like. But it has its charm, you know, it has its charm. It's nice.
It's short.
Yep. Yep.
It's short and sweet. Alright, you got anything else?
Nah.
Alright, that was Ooyasan wa Shishunki. On to the next one, which is Oshiete Galko-chan. This shit's hilarious. I don't know why.
It's like, so it is going to be every episode where it's like high school myths and stuff, right? Yeah,
basically.
That bread dough one. That had me thinking.
Thinking about what?
Bread dough.
Oh my god. The fucking dude. So this is what they feel like.
I like how they're all just fucking eavesdropping on all their conversations.
This is fun. And then when we're at the supermarket, picking out the fucking feminine products.
Yeah.
You're like, oh my god, she's experienced. What was the third one?
They were talking about colors.
Oh, yeah,
colors
color
of yeah. And then they got the colors wrong.
Yeah, that one dude saw it.
Was it this episode or was it the first one there where they were like, yeah, she totally likes me?
It was, I think it was this one.
Just all three of them?
Yeah.
That's about all I got for this.
Yeah, me too. Oh, you're dead, dude. It's late. Alright. That was Oshiete Galko-chan. This next one. Why did you miss like three anime?
Dude, he does have his headphones in here. Moises, we're done.
Yeah, we're done.
No, you're not. Except the fucking Marshmallow one, the fucking. Unless I did that one already. The other one with the high school, the little middle school girl.
We did those. Do you have something you want to add?
Did I talk about the other one already?
We did the Ooyasan and Galko-chan.
The two short ones.
The oh shit.
Yeah.
Fantasy.
We're doing that one right now. Or we're about to start.
We're
that
just
one.
Now.
Oh, I don't have anything for those. Yeah, now I care about those.
Alright. This episode right here. Freaking. What the fuck? What do you think that girl's trying to do? You know?
Which one? The blonde?
Yeah.
I don't know, but she.
Stay with him the whole time, maybe?
So real?
Yeah.
She
made him that one. She's trying to
train him and not be so rogue anymore.
What? What?
This is some dude who's, you know, doesn't have any.
Oh, not like, Soro, the blonde dude. The blonde girl.
So yeah, we're talking about the blonde girl.
The one that was like referring to everything in like military term.
Yeah, the one that the new transfer student.
She didn't want to play.
Um,
this is
Oh, yeah, I don't know what she's up to.
Like, freaking measuring him, checking out his dick.
That should make me laugh whenever he, like, laid down and then opened his eyes and, what the fuck? How'd you get in here?
I kind of laughed at that part where they're at the tables and it was all the girls at that table. And they were and then whenever the dude left, like the redhead guy, he went to the girls' table.
Oh, yeah. Can I come over to the party? I like how the girl, when she walked away, she was like, aye, who is that?
Doesn't even know she was invited to a party. Her own party.
Yeah.
Friggin' the new guy will pee quick.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You just need to get the mindset right.
I wish games were really like that.
They're like that.
Are you lying? You can't fucking do flips and shit.
Well, this is fucking...
I can in Monster Hunter as a vault guy.
Oh, that's true. It's not like any game looks like that.
This is the one that made me want to start hunting again.
Mm-hmm.
Do y'all want to hunt?
No.
I feel like if I hunt again, I'm going to have to restart from level 1.
Why?
Hey, I'll restart with you.
You're going to be the staff again?
Your character doesn't have levels.
Oh, shit, you're right.
Bish. No. This is pretty good. Friggin', you think he's gonna, like, change arm as well? Like how he did with the sword?
No, because his class is specifically so his sword changes.
No, but, like, remember in the first one he had that, like, black-looking sword, but then in this one he had that orange and black one.
That wasn't just like a sword change, that what his class does?
No.
No, I think the only change that it does is when it goes from sword to
gun. Yeah, sword to gun.
It's an RPG. Of course he's going to upgrade his armor along the way.
Then it's going to be good. So you got anything for this one, Moses?
No.
I feel like it's just going to be like... It's gonna look the same, but it's stronger armor. I don't know why.
Because in the fucking intro, they show him with like three different armors, don't they?
I don't fucking know. I don't watch intros. Okay.
Right. Maybe his armor changes, because you know how his class is all... Yeah, maybe his armor changes with his sword and stuff.
Oh. Not because he had the same armor he was wearing. But
I mean, now he's like level 2. Like, maybe he'll get some like awesome armor later that changes with it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, it adapts.
Yeah.
We'll see. That was Phantasy Star Online 2, the animation. This super hype one right here, Prince of Stride Alternative. Friggin'. Yeah.
I like the whole concept of just beyond love. Like,. Like, that's their goal, is beyond love.
Mm. Freaking, is gonna, they're freaking doing all that shit for that one dude's sister.
That dude, that poor guy in the girl's dress.
I thought to be honest.
Oh, shit.
Oh, here it comes. Here it comes, yep.
Freaking! I thought it was a girl.
Oh!
Oh, I thought you were gonna say something different.
Because he thought it was a girl. He probably thought she was attractive.
Yeah.
But then I was like, oh shit, that's that one.
You still found him attractive.
Oh, he's ugly.
Freaking! You got a girl right now.
Oh man, I had something for that. I just realized I had something for that.
Which one?
One of the short ones.
Oh.
Don't worry about it.
What? Okay.
Get to it next time.
I'm sure y'all talked to it. I just talked about it already. Like, y'all brought it up.
Yeah. Freaking. How do y'all think they're going to do in that, the first meet?
Yes. You're going to win.
You're going to win?
The first what?
No, they're going to lose.
I mean, because they're up against that, like, super badass school.
Oh, man.
They're either going to lose because they mess up, or they're going to win because they're good.
Beyond love.
Beyond love. Yeah. All
right. You got anything else?
Nope.
Nah. All right. That was Prince of Stride Alternative. This, the next one that we got.
Finally.
Next episode.
Oh, a Full Metal Alchemist?
Yeah. Full Metal Alchemist, Hunter x Hunter.
I like how it even has alchemy in it.
Yeah, dude. That shit is pretty cool. This one's called Reikenzan, Hoshikuzu Tachi no Utage.
Translated to Full Metal Alchemist Season 2.
yeah, this one.
Alternate dimension.
This is pretty good.
Yeah, pretty good.
Yeah.
I'm digging it.
It's at least going to be an 8.
This one was also like, sooner than I thought. I thought it was going to be super serious.
And yeah, it looked like it's going to be all, like, you know, sad story, shit, just losing everything on the way.
Nah. Yeah.
Freaking, I like how he got the people to buy that cabbage. Or not the cabbage, the radish.
Oh, it's that one guy!
He doesn't know that guy now. Like,
yeah.
No matter what he does, he's
never gonna be.
What the fuck? Who's?
Right.
What?
There's like a rapper going on. That's Fernando.
Oh.
What the fuck, man, dude?
You should totally stop that.
They didn't fly very far.
I landed right in front of them.
What was it that the guy that had the two bodyguards, what did he pick up that the girl dropped?
The pouch. Was it the pouch with the key and the...
So it was, it had the key and the coin in it? All right.
Yeah.
Well, there goes his chance to winning.
That's how you guys say he's going to join his team. He's going to be like, hey, I found this.
Yeah,
oh, really, dude?
He lost his bodyguard, so... He's all alone.
Probably gonna be like, true.
He's going to be like, hey, you be my bodyguard, you get this.
Yeah.
Oh, for real. Damn, I didn't think about that. That fat bitch.
This is, I'm going to like this one. I'm probably going to give it a 9, maybe. What about you, Moise?
I'm going to give that a 9 as well. All
right. That was Full Metal Alchemist. I mean, Reikenzan,
you seriously fucked that up, or were you just fucking...
It's for the fans. It's for the watchers.
Like, oh, you actually fucked that up.
All right, Josh, this one's all for you. Tabi Machi Late Show.
Oh. All right, so you remember how last week I was wondering if it was just going to be, like, the same people?
Yeah.
And, like, you know, the same person is going to have to say goodbye over and over. Because, you know, the description is farewells and goodbyes.
Yeah.
Found out this episode, it's actually going to be a different story each episode. Oh, and this episode was actually pretty heartwarming to me.
Did you cry?
No, but I even wrote down the little, what is it called?
Wrote down some
morale or lesson that she, moral. But it's not even like a moral, it's just... This is like a hindsight 2020 type deal.
Common sense. All
right. So this is what she was telling herself while she was at the end of the episode, thinking back on her life. Maybe you only ever realize who you should have been friends with after it's too late.
Damn. Mm.
I feel like I've heard that before.
Yeah, that might have been said somewhere before.
Yes, this is like a rule.
But, like, the story is, I'm not going to go over the whole story, but the main character in this episode, she tried being friends with some other person during school, and they argued, and they never talked again. But later on, as she's sitting there saying that quote, like, regretting not trying to be that person's friend anymore, that person, like, emails her, and that's the end of the episode. But it was a nice little heartwarming episode.
Cool. All right, that was Tabi Machi Late Show. On to Sayajaku Muhai no Bahamut.
Yay! That ending. But yeah, like that power.
I mean,
whenever he was just flying around, just exploding every single robot.
She was bad. Whenever his first armor got fucked, and then like he took it off, and then like I saw him reaching around, I'm like, oh shit, it's the black sword.
Yeah, I didn't think it was gonna come in this early in the season.
Yeah, me too. I was like, damn, that was badass.
Yeah, this was pretty cool. Forgetting.
Yes.
I'm liking how the plot's getting more complex with the brother of the prince too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, what do you guys think about the princess having a male assistant?
I mean, no different than a female assistant.
This is pretty funny. The beginning was pretty funny.
I like his voice actor.
Yeah.
Is his brother still alive?
Maybe.
I guess we'll find out on that.
Because he might have to face him.
Oh, yeah, they're definitely going to have a nice little clash of ideals.
Duke it out.
Yeah, freaking whenever you look up next to the girl.
Oh, yeah. She was like, this feels good.
Yeah.
What did you think of that, Josh?
Nah.
Those things look really big. Anything else? You got anything else?
That was hype. I mean, everyone asking him favors and stuff.
Yeah. Isn't he the only guy?
He's a boy. Yeah.
That would have been like, F off.
Wow.
Are you lying?
I'm not doing,
whatever.
I'm not doing nothing for y'all. I mean, if they're trying to get you to work for them for free.
That's a damn lie.
No, it's not for... That's like he's supposed to give back for... He was a part of the old empire. Like, it's amazing that they kept him alive in the first place. He's like seen as their enemy.
I mean, it's not like they could have killed him because of that armor.
Maybe he didn't have it at first.
Yeah, like, I'm sure they wanted to kill him.
It's not like he was the first one to have it.
Yeah.
His brother might be dead, that's how he got it.
Yep. And then, yes, girl, with that green mech.
That one princess chick with the brand, was she the only one that saw him turn into the black armor, whatever.
Well, other than the rebels.
His sister.
Well, yeah, like, I meant from the school. Did anyone else see him?
His sister.
If his sister saw him, I'm sure everybody saw
it. Didn't his sister know?
Well, she probably just had a feeling. She probably just felt it. It was like, this nigga fucking
up. I mean, everyone saw the thunder and everything.
Yeah.
But did they see him actually
turn into
the night?
I'm sure they could assume what happened.
Yeah. I mean, like, Black Sword, Black Knight appears. You put two and two together.
No one was there to see the Black Knight, except that chick.
Like, if it was just the princess, then now they both have secrets that they like together, that they're sharing. So, at least there's going to be that.
I mean, I like anime where the main character is OP, yeah.
All right, you got anything else?
That's my point.
All right, that was Saijaku Muhai no Bahamut. Schwartz's marking is next.
Watch, no, at the beginning of the next episode, that chick with the flower in his hair is gonna die by trying to save the other chick's life.
What's up, Fernando? Why are you gonna predict that?
Watch.
Hold on, dude. They're both alive.
The episode ended whenever that monster jumped on the...
No, it didn't. There's stuff what? After the there's stuff after the oh, credits.
Oh, he
dude.
Didn't watch the extra.
There's stuff after the credits, bro.
Yeah, they had a little extra thing at the end of the credits.
You thought it ended there?
Damn. What happened?
They're both like they're alive, but they both got knocked out. And their armor and their armor got fucked.
So then the red haired dude is gonna swoop in.
I mean, maybe.
Probably.
Yeah,
he's gonna be like, Kimiki.
I don't know. Because the Stasi showed up at their base.
Yeah. They were trying to take the one chick with
them.
Mm.
Is that a reference to like one of the Nazi like sub groups that there were? Like was one of them
Nazi in general, just a different way of saying it.
Like was Stasi in one of those names?
I'm not
because
so
I feel
sure,
like because but... when you think Germany, most countries think, oh yeah, Nazis.
Like I thought they were just. That's what they were calling them instead of Nazis. They were calling Stasi.
Man, I feel like that was some messed up stuff. Whenever they were getting their ass handed to them, and then they're like,
fucking no reinforcements.
And the lady's like looking at her robot.
She's just I never thought anyone could look so evil looking tea or drinking
and
tea.
The other guy's just like looking out the window. Going great. Man, that was some messed up stuff.
I didn't like that speech that she made as valedictorian.
Yeah. That speech right there.
Wait to see you give a speech.
Yeah, let's see you give a speech as valedictorian.
True.
Oh, this would be Josh.
Yes.
Well, there is.
We did it.
He had to flip his hands in the air.
Do I have anything else?
I'm good.
No, you're just,
yeah, you're and good. That's my last anime from the list.
Bye for later.
This next one, the Shoujo-tachi.
This one right here.
I like this.
You do or you don't?
I like this.
Oh, you like it? Yeah. it's good.
Freaking whenever all those guys showed up, I'm a programmer, but I never actually programmed.
Oh yeah.
I'm an artist, but I've never really drawn something.
That guy. Those guys were fucking retarded. Man.
And then whenever they went to, where'd they go? Shibuya or Akihabara?
I think they went to like.
When they Akihabara.
They went to Akihabara.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
That guy started freaking out, like, oh my god!
He fucking fell down the stairs. So that's what Dojin.
Oh man. I like how he went into that one restaurant, and then runs into that other chick, and the chick is like acting totally different, you know, because of her job. And then every so often she whispers here, keep this a secret. That right there. That was pretty funny.
Who knew that she could program?
Yeah.
She did. She knew what she was capable of.
Right.
And then whenever they slipped that note into that girl's locker.
Oh, she's kind of like, oh my god, what was this from?
She's funny. Yeah. I like her.
Yeah.
Oh, my phone.
I like how they had her in the room. Well, no, whenever he kept popping up in other places, it was like, I need to talk to you. I need to talk to you. And they finally, like, he's waiting outside of the bathroom.
Oh,
it was weird.
Y'all got anything else?
You notice how on the second scene when he was standing outside of the bathroom and the red-haired girl went inside, you notice how two other girls standing behind the guy, like looking at him, like, what the fuck are you doing? That shit made me laugh.
Anything else?
That's about it for that.
All right. I'm gonna stay quiet for this one because I don't know what the fuck this anime for older women.
Man.
Oh. Showa Genroku Rakugo Shinju.
I was laughing in this one too. I'm really liking it. Yeah, I'm liking the stories that they're telling.
Yeah.
I don't know about this older women bullshit, but
yeah, I don't. I think it was just because it's made by older women that they're assuming the genre is for older women.
It doesn't seem like it.
That sounds like something like
an older. Well, you like guys dressed as girls.
Yeah, what are we gonna take your word on?
Yeah, bitch.
I know what the kids like.
That's fucking weird.
It just sounds crazy.
Yeah.
I want the kids like.
You do.
Oh man, nah. I liked it. How they introduced the two characters in the beginning, and like they're totally opposite.
One of them,
you know, out there, great character, great. You know, I'm ready to be the first disciple of this guy or whatever.
Yeah.
And then like the other dude's like, yeah, I'm just here.
Nothing else to do.
Yeah.
Okay, he's just like, he didn't want to be one or something like that.
I like how it's that guy, the one who didn't want to be there. I like how it's him who's the successor though.
Yeah.
There's two successors.
Whoa.
I mean, in a way.
And I also like how the current guy who just got out of prison. I like how he's taking after the other guy.
Yeah.
The hooligan one?
Yeah. I like how he's taking after his style.
Yep.
He's going to be the next Hokage. The next... What the fuck? What is it? Rakugo?
Yeah.
The next Hokage. I don't know what that girl's doing, though. She's fucking retarded.
Man. She's going to take after a serious one. Yeah. That's going to suck.
Damn. He's okay, though.
Yeah, but she's going to have a harder time because, like, just like how the original two guys, the one who's more outgoing, even though he was messing up a lot, he was still getting laughs and stuff. It's going to be harder for the more serious ones.
Was it messing up?
Yeah. It was the guy who's all happy, he rushes through his stories and stuff. And then the guy who's all serious, he's not outgoing enough.
Well, then he played that shit off really well, because...
Oh, yeah.
I couldn't tell. The OP.
Mm-hmm.
Of the OP.
Yeah, that's all I got.
Have somebody tell me a story like that one day.
I'm going to try to rush it out of nowhere, you know.
Is that like... Oh, okay.
I don't know if you noticed that whenever he started sweating because he could tell that, you know, his story wasn't doing any effect to the crowd. And then when the second guy goes out, he's like, you didn't even practice last night. How do you think you can do this if I couldn't do it? And then he just goes out there and he rushed the story, but, you know, he
still pulled it off.
Yeah.
And he played it off.
What?
I knew he was just going to scream really loud to get everybody's attention.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey! Whoop! Yeah. And that old guy.
is Rakugo like a real thing? Like currently still?
I don't know.
I don't know about currently, but I'm pretty sure they used to have it.
Well, oh, yeah. Like I'm guessing this is just similar to like how our stand-up comedians are.
Yeah. I said they just have like, you know, little short stories that they
it's
tell.
It's more of a serious Japanese twist to it.
Yeah.
And earlier than ours.
Yeah. I like it.
Yeah, I'm really liking it too.
Yeah. I like the music. I like that's what I like the most of it. Like the nice jazz that they put in there every so often. It's really nice. Yeah, got anything else to say about it?
Nah.
All right, that was Rakugo. Rakugo. This next one is the best ever.
The best of the season.
The best anime ever, because it's all about food. It's Sushi Police.
Jesus Christ.
This shit's
so bad. I dreamed of being a Sushi Police when I grew up. That's what I'm majoring in.
I watched this episode, so there you go.
That's what I'm majoring in.
I think Josh said he had like two notes, but I'm sure one of them was just like a slap.
I had one note for this. Hold on, let me try.
He said he had two.
I can't find it.
Damn.
Oh, wait, there it is. See those dots? Yeah, that's my note.
Like four dots.
Forget about illegal foil. Illegal sushi. That's what it's all about.
It's not even... How is it even illegal?
It's not real fish, maybe? I don't know.
Yeah, but the chicken at McDonald's isn't real chicken, but...
Yeah.
You see people going around. What?
Oh, really? Yeah, I'm about to go shoot them down.
There's not a specific organization.
Yeah, have you heard of the chicken nugget police? No.
What the fuck? Josh could be the chicken nugget police.
Yeah, Josh, you should be the chicken nugget police, but then you'd have to shut down McDonald's.
Can't just critique fast food because they're about speed. You got to go to like real restaurants.
If you want speed, you go play Sonic.
What the fuck?
Y'all got anything else to say about this?
It sucks.
that was Sushi Police, and with that, that was the last anime we're gonna do. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe. Call me.
Give suggestions of things you would like to see.
No.
Fine.
Give Josh suggestions.
Hold on.
Call him at 214.
What the fuck?
Ooh.
At 911.
Hit him up on 911. That's his number.
Right. Oh, that reminded me of Ace Ventura.
The MC Myers.
Say bye, everybody. Say bye, everybody.
See bye, man. Ya.
Deuces.
Fuck.
You're not gonna say bye, Moses?
Fuck you.